In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you, and also with you. My brothers and sisters, with hearts full of gratitude and jubilation, we gather today around the table of the Lord's Word and Sacrament as His chosen people called to holiness, sharing in the one priesthood of Christ and participating in Christ's mission as priest, prophet, and king. We will also witness the immensity of God's love, and relying on the abundance of His love and grace, we ordain our brother, Reverend Jomar Marquez Castan, through the laying on of hands and the invocation of the Holy Spirit. He will be consecrated as God's servant and minister of His church, leading His people through service, proclaiming His word through His words and deeds, and celebrating the mysteries of His love. As we prepare to celebrate this mystery of Christ's love, let us implore the forgiveness by which we are renewed and saved. I confess, Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned by my holy angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, O Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord our God, who in governing your people make use of the ministry of priests, grant this deacon of your church, whom you graciously choose today for the office of the priesthood, the strength of perseverance serving your will, so that by his ministry and life he may gain glory for you in Christ your Son, who lives and reigns with you and in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Let us all be seated for the liturgy of the word.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring glad tidings to the lowly, to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to announce a year of favor from the Lord and a day of vindication by our God, to comfort all who mourn, to place on those who mourn in Zion a diadem instead of ashes, to give them oil of gladness in place of mourning, a glorious mantle instead of a listless spirit. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. For us in one body, we have many parts, and all the parts do not have the same function. So we, though many, are one body in Christ, and individually parts of one another. Since we have many gifts that differ according to the grace given to us, let us exercise them. If prophecy, in proportion to the faith. If ministry, in ministering. If one is a teacher, in teaching. If one exhorts, in exhortation. If one contributes, in generosity. If one is over others, with diligence. If one does acts of mercy, with cheerfulness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us all stand to honor the Holy Gospel. Summoned his disciples and said to them, "You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and the great ones make their authority over them felt. But it shall not be so among you. Rather, whoever wishes to be great among you shall be your servant. Whoever wishes to be first among you shall be your slave. Just so, the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many." The Gospel of the Lord.
Let us all be seated. Now we shall witness the rite of ordination to the priesthood of Reverend Jomar Marquez Castaneda. The candidate is first called upon to remind us that the priesthood is first of all an initiative of God who instills the desire in the hearts of those whom He has chosen. After the calling will be the election of the candidate. Reverend Father Lai Mayo will present the candidate to the bishop. The bishop will then ask about his worthiness and elects him for ordination upon the assurance given and relying on God's assistance.
Let Reverend Jomar Castaneda E. Marquez, who is to be ordained priest, please come forward.
Present. Reverend Father Lain Mayo, the rector of the Immaculate Conception Major Seminary, will Invigan Ilocos Sur, will now present Reverend Castaneda.
Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asked you to ordain this man, our brother, to the office of priest.
Do you know him to be worthy?
After inquiry among the Christian people and upon the recommendation of those concerned with his formation, I testify that he has been found worthy.
Relying on the help of the Lord God and our Savior Jesus Christ, we choose this, our brother, for the order of the priesthood. Thanks be to God. Let us all give him a round of applause. Let us now listen to the homily of our beloved bishop. Reverend Fathers, clergy of the Diocese of Ilagan, Reverend Sisters, religious, parents, family, and relatives of Reverend Jomar, all of you who have come from different parts of the diocese to be present today, brothers and sisters in Christ, good morning. Before we started this celebration, Reverend Jomar approached me and said, Bishop, do you have any last words? I said, last words are for the dying. And I said, I will say what I have to tell you during the homily. And I see that the world is becoming bright because as soon as I sang the Gloria, the world darkened. I hope it's not going to rain because I sang. And during these days, you have been together with us in different celebrations in the diocese. Ordinations, jubilees, special Sunday celebrations. I am running out of words to say. But then I thought it is much better to use the words of Scripture in this reflection than trying to make my own. It has always been the principle of preaching that sometimes we kill the mystery by too many human words. So So if I did make my own words today, I risk talking too much without saying anything, because my words are not the words of God. Today, we have this event, and it is celebrated in the shadow of Christ the King that we celebrated yesterday. Today also, we celebrate the presentation of Mary, our Lady. Both feasts simply express the reality of response to the call of God. Jesus, the firstborn, offered himself according to the book of Leviticus, stipulating that every firstborn be presented to the Lord. And this feast that we celebrate today, the presentation of Mary, although it is based on apocrypha, it is not contrary to common sense. In fact, sensus fidelium gives us a direction to give meaning to our celebration today. For it reinforces the conviction that God is not a respecter of persons, but deals equally with each one of us. And what St. Paul says, apropos to the identity of all Christians, in Christ there is no longer Jew or Greek, free man or slaves, male or female, but we are one in Jesus Christ. Sisters and brothers, I am not trying to imply that because of this, women may be ordained. Maybe that will come when we are dead already. But what I simply want to emphasize today is the fact that, as Lumen Gentium would say, we have received the equal call to holiness of life and conduct. But I notice that before Jesus called the 12 to be his apostles, they were his disciples first. And my reflection on this is that there should already be a disposition in the person to be able to respond to the call. It is something that the Spirit has already planted in the hearts of the person long before he or she hears the call. I have studied the lives of saints, our heroes and heroines in the faith, and I have found this constant pattern. And most of the time, we mistake other qualities for holiness, such as popularity, excellent human or even spiritual qualities, brilliant theological insights, great skills at organizing, spectacular achievements. But sainthood or holiness is something hidden that we are sometimes in difficulty to spot the marks of true holiness. But I discovered 5 marks of holiness. And number one, it is spotting a person who listens first than speaking. Because listening is the core of prayer. We can only hear the voice of God among many other voices of the world when we are in silence and in solitude. And we hear the gentle voice that Elijah also heard in the cave when he was before the Lord and he was suffering from isolation and desperation. Number 2, holiness is when a person centers his or her life on the Eucharist. That means the personal encounter with the person of Jesus. And it's also an encounter with the church, where he resides among his people. Number three, a holy person will always be able to see Christ in the poor and the disadvantaged. That means he or she puts others before self. Number four quality of holiness is being obedient to the promptings of the Spirit. And therefore discernment is very important in our Christian life, in our journey for wholeness. And finally, fifth mark, a holy person creates community. It is not creating divisions or factions, because when we look at the Greek words used to express this reality, symbols are the coincidence of opposites. We bring together disparate realities still in unity. But division, we know, is diabol, and we know that this is the work of evil. That's why we say it is diabolic spirit that creates enmity. It creates division in our midst. Sisters and brothers, these marks constitute the conditions sine qua non for meaningful service. Without this grounding, there is a risk that we become simple functionaries in the church. Our activities risk the definition of being mercenary instead of reflecting the person of Jesus, our high priest. The letter to the Hebrews says this to us: it is fitting that we should have a high priest, holy, innocent, beyond reproach, undefiled, separated from sinners, higher than the heavens. We in the priesthood, we ordain someone to service of the community, following this pattern of our high priest. And we also believe that because of this, he participates in the one priesthood of Jesus. He is taken from among men and made their representative before God to offer gifts and sacrifices for our sins. And it goes on to say, and this is what we wish to see in our ordained ministers. The author of the letter to the Hebrews says, he is then able to deal patiently with the ignorant and the erring, for he himself is beset with weaknesses, and so for this reason must make sin offering for himself as well as for the people. For no one takes his honor but only when called by God. Brother Jomar, and all of us attending this celebration today, we are all in need of God's grace and mercy. And we as a priestly people should pray for one another, not criticize one another, but bear one another's burdens. Practice one of the most difficult spiritual habits, fraternal correction and constructive criticism. And we do this because we show the love of Christ that urges us to a life of sacrifice and self-emptying. And I will summarize all this in the letter of Paul to the Philippians. God exalted Jesus Christ, who humbled himself, forgetting that he was God, and took the form of a slave. And he was exalted far above the heavens. And he is now seated at the right hand of God. To him, we commend ourselves. We commend our brother, Jomar Castaneda. You will please remain seated. The candidate to the priesthood will now express his readiness and willingness to accept the threefold mission that Christ entrusts him, namely that of being a shepherd, priest, and teacher of God's own people. My dear son, before you enter the order of the priesthood, you must declare before the your intention to undertake this office. Do you resolve with the help of the Holy Spirit to discharge without fail the office of priesthood in the presbyteral rank as a worthy fellow worker with me and the order of bishops in caring for the Lord's flock?
I do.
Do you resolve to exercise the ministry of the word worthily and wisely, preaching the gospel and teaching the Catholic faith?
I do.
Do you resolve to celebrate faithfully and reverently, in accord with the Church's tradition, the mysteries of Christ, especially the sacrifice of the Eucharist and the sacrament of reconciliation, for the glory of God and the sanctification of the Christian people?
I do.
Do you believe and you resolve to be united more closely every day to Christ, the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a pure sacrifice, with him to consecrate yourself to Christ for the salvation of all?
I do, with the help of God.
Obedience marks the authentic disciples of the Lord, and it is a guarantee of unity of the Church. Our priest elect will now promise respect and obedience. Do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successor?
I do.
May God, who has begun this good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Performing the work that goes with the order of priests is in itself a challenge. Because man is weak and sinful, we need the assistance and intercessions of the saints, so that God will accept our brother into his service and give him the graces necessary as he offers his life to the service of the Church. Together with him, let us all stand. My dearly beloved, let us pray that God, the all-powerful Father, will pour out abundantly the gifts of heaven on this servant whom he has chosen for the office of priest. Let us all kneel.
Abu ikan lo kami, Yawa mo paray, tumataraday ng amin itutulay, tataloan na imam mo. Yawa mo paray, tumapakaladay pa servimi ni ka. Tagapiyam mo nga bendisyonan si Jomar. Tagapiyam mo nga bendisyonan si Jomar, ang napakasantuang mo yaya. Agapiyam mo nga bendisyonan si Jomar, pakasantuan mo, para tamasanto nga anong nga.
Ako din ako'y papale.
Jesus, anak na agamatol ay adiyos.
Hear us, we beseech you, Lord our God, and pour out on this servant of yours the blessing of the Holy Spirit and the power of priestly grace, that this man whom we offer on the side of your mercy to be consecrated may be surrounded by your rich and unfailing gifts. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us all stand. We now approach the heart of the rite of the ordination. The laying on of hands, and the prayer of ordination. The bishop will now lay his hands on the candidate. Likewise, the concelebrating priests will do the same. This is a gesture preserved from the apostolic tradition used to signify the handing on of the gifts and strength of the Holy Spirit. Let us witness this sacred and solemn act in prayerful silence. Draw near, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, Author of human dignity and distributor of all graces, through whom all things progress, through whom all things are made to stand firm, to form a priestly people, you appoint ministers of Christ, your Son, by the power of the Holy Spirit, arranging them in different orders. Already in the earlier covenant, there grew up offices established by mystical rites, as when you set Moses and Aaron over your people to govern and sanctify them, you choose men next in rank and dignity to accompany them and assist them in their task. So too in the desert, you implant the spirit of Moses in the hearts of 70 wise men. With their help, he ruled your people with greater ease. So also upon the sons of Aaron, you poured an abundant share in their father's plenty, and the number of the priests prescribed by the law might be sufficient for the sacrifices of the tabernacle, which were a shadow of the good things to come. But in these last days, Holy Father, you sent your Son into the world, Jesus, who is apostle and high priest of our confession. Through his Holy Spirit, he offered himself unblemished to you, and he made his apostles partners in his mission, consecrated in the truth. You provided them also with companions to proclaim and carry out the work of salvation throughout the whole world. And so now, we beseech you, Lord, in our weakness, to grant us this helper we need to exercise the priesthood that comes from the apostles. Almighty Father, grant, we pray, to this servant of yours, the dignity of the priesthood. Renew deep within him the spirit of holiness. May he cling to this office next in rank to our own, which he receives from you, Lord, and by his manner of life may be an example of rightful conduct. May he be a worthy co-worker with our order, so that by his preaching and through the grace of the Holy Spirit, the words of the gospel that bear fruit in human hearts and reach even the ends of the earth. Together with us, may he be a faithful steward of your mysteries, so that your people may be renewed the waters of rebirth and nourished from your altar, that sinners may be reconciled and the sick raised up. May he be joined with us, Lord, in imploring your mercy for the people entrusted to his care, and for all the world as well. Thus, may the full number of the nations gathered together in Christ be transformed into your one people and made perfect in your kingdom. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Let us all be seated. The newly ordained will now be clothed with priestly vestments. The chasuble, the outer garment covering the priest's body, speaks of the fact that in his priestly functions, he acts in the name of the person of Christ. The stole is the symbol of priestly dignity. Father Jomar will be assisted, donning his vestments by his parents, Father Jerry Dakiwag, and Father Alden Zulueta, his parish priest in San Isidro, Labrador, San Guillermo. Now garb in his priestly vestments, we give a round of applause to our Reverend Father, Jomar. The hands of a priest are instruments used by God to sanctify his people. The bishop will now anoint the hands of the newly ordained priest with a sacred chrism in order to show that he is now God's unique possession and his holy channel of grace for the whole world. Father anointed our Lord Jesus Christ through the power of the Holy Spirit. May Jesus preserve you to sanctify the Christian people and to offer sacrifice to God. The central act of the priest is the offering of the Eucharistic sacrifice. From the hands of the community and the ordaining bishop, the newly ordained priest now receives the gifts of bread and wine, the elements in the Eucharistic celebration. Accept from the holy people of God the gifts to be offered to him. Know that what you are doing and imitate the mystery you celebrate, model your life on the mystery of the Lord's cross. As a sign of welcome into the communion of God's ordained ministers, the bishop and all the priests will now give the newly ordained the kiss of peace. As we continue the celebration of the Holy Eucharist, Reverend Father Jomar Marquez Castaneda will now begin to exercise his ministry. He will for the first time concelebrate with the Bishop in the Holy Eucharist. May we be reminded, dear friends, that only the gifts for the Holy Mass shall be brought forward. We may give our personal gifts for the newly ordained priest after the Mass. Your personal gifts will be given after the Mass. Sisters and brothers, let us now pray so that this sacrifice of ours, yours and mine, may be made acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church. O God, you have willed that your priests should minister at your holy altar and serve your people. Mercifully grant that by the power of this sacrifice, the ministry of this your servant may always be pleasing to you and bear in your church fruit that lasts forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is truly fitting and right, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. By the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son, High Priest of the new and eternal covenant. And by your ineffable plan, you were pleased to ordain that many ministries should be carried out within the church. For Christ can only accord the dignity of royal priesthood to the people he has made his own. But he also chooses men with a brother's care to receive a share in his sacred ministry by the laying on of hands. He chooses them to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with your word, and to renew them through the sacraments. As they offer their lives to you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they are to strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and to offer you their constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, we join all the angels and saints in their joyous hymn of your praise. Lord, you are holy indeed, the fountain of all holiness. Let your Spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before he was given up to death, the dead they freely accepted, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." This is the mystery of faith. Let us joyfully proclaim.
Let us all rise.
In memory of his death and resurrection, we offer your Father this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. May all of us who share the body and blood of Christ be brought together in unity by the Holy Spirit.
Lord, remember your church throughout the world, because growing love together with Benedict, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also this your servant, whom you have chosen today to be a priest of the church.
Remember our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest in the hope of rising again. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles, and with all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Let us now pray for the coming of the kingdom as our Lord Jesus Christ has taught us.
Keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I give you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, for you live forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always,
and also with you.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Behold, this is our Lord Jesus Christ, our High Priest, who gave his life for our redemption, the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those that are invited to share at his banquet.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. To allow an orderly flow of the communion rite, the priests will be assisted by the ushers. We will all receive communion at designated places. Please follow the designated places. To allow a smooth flow of the communion, please follow the designated places.
Oh. Let us pray. Let the divine sacrifice we have offered and received, O Lord, give new life for your priests and all your servants, so that bound to you in unfailing charity, they may offer worthy service to your majesty. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Dear friends, on the ordination to the diaconate of Reverend Haji Galisa, to be celebrated at the Our Lady of the Visitation Seminary, Major Seminary in San Fermin, Cagayan City. Later this afternoon, Father Jomar will celebrate his Thanksgiving Mass at the parish of St. Ferdinand Parish with Father June Castaneda as the host. The time of the Misa de Gracia will be at 5:15 in the afternoon. For the reception, it is by colors. You will please proceed to your designated places because there are food enough for all of us. We now listen to our newly ordained priest, Reverend Father Jomar Marquez Castañeda.
Before anything else, there was one song that was not sung for communion, which is supposed to be my theme song. So may I ask the choir concerned to please stand up and sing it now. The title of the song is Heart of a Servant. The lyrics of the song was written by Madame Fran Quitoriano, who is here. And the music was written by Sister no less than Sister Anunciata Santa Ana SBC. Ladies and gentlemen, the theme song of my ordination.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Again, all my thanks to my friend and Sister Menchata SBC for that beautiful song. Whoever wishes to be great among you shall be your servant. When Jesus was tempted by the devil in the desert, he was offered three things: to turn stone to bread, to throw himself down the parapet of the temple to prove that angels will eventually catch him, and to have all the kingdoms and treasures of the world. In modern times, according to the great spiritual writer Henry Nouwen, these are the temptations to be relevant, the temptation to be spectacular, and the temptation to be powerful. To be very honest with you, these temptations were there ever since I heard the announcement that I was being ordained. To rid me of them, I decided to distract myself and take a walk the other day and observe how people are getting ready and working for the Christ the King yesterday and for the ordination of today. The 5th Infantry Battalion of the Philippine Army, through the assistance of Reverend Father Jerome Daluro, thank you very much. The Philippine National Police of Gamu, through Police Inspector Pio Pascual Añares III, thank you for providing traffic for today. The workforce from ISU, through my cousins Manong Efren and Edwin Timosa, thank you very much. The workforce of San Isidro Labrador Parish, San Guillermo, headed by no less than Reverend Father Alden Zueta, and Sir Deo Lucas and the rest of the Parish Pastoral Council. Ma'am Chik Munsayak and the flower arrangement team, thank you very much. The Parish Pastoral Council of St. Ferdinand Cathedral, headed by the very able Mrs. Jenny Zicarelli, a team always challenged by great and almost impossible tasks, but still finds time to laugh at themselves in the midst of the work that they do. It was a very wonderful experience working with you. To Piazza Zicarelli for accommodations and catering services. To the Chancery personnel, thank you for the accommodations and the assistance. Golden Press to Bigarao, to Mrs. Bilendim, Maribon Print House, to my cousin Manang Von, thank you very much for the assistance with the printing services. To Badong Photography, thank you, Sir Marjun, for covering the event, and thank you for the services you have done for our diocese. Advanced thanks to the St. Ferdinand College, St. Ferdinand Parish, Ilagan, headed by my uncle, Reverend Father June Castaneda, and Sir Butch Bulan, and the rest of the Parish Pastoral Council of Ilagan. I appreciate and I was shocked by the preparations you have made last night. Our Lady of the Pillar College, Kawayan, headed by Sir Vin Flores, who could not make it today, for the generous assistance for my invitations and the ushering services and the technical services for my souvenirs. The choir for this celebration is composed of 4 different groups. First, we have the Power Voice and Friends from Ilagan. Please stand to be recognized. The Our Lady of the Pillar College Choir from Kawayan. Please stand to be recognized. The Core Group Choir, composed of the different representatives from the different choirs of the Our Lady of the Pillar Parish in Kawayan. Please stand to be recognized. And last but not the least, and last but not the least, the Couples for Christ Global from Kawayan City. Please remember the first time we met and how you sounded as a group. And now listen to yourselves. You made my life busier but more meaningful by the little improvements I hear. The purpose of gathering you here today is not to showcase your groups, as I've always told you, but to teach you that the only way to learn and to improve in your craft is to use it to serve others. Thank you for letting me inside your lives as your choir director, and I will scold you for your mistakes later. To our soloists, Ate Chris and Brother Sam, thank you for singing the litany and the responsorial song. To the organist, Mr. Jomar Ivanalo, It was a privilege. I've been working with you these past years. I hope for more musical collaborations. For our strings ensemble by Ma'am Angel Eslava, thank you very much. To Fathers Zook and Father Ayan, thank you very much for the great help in the liturgy and the preparations. To my classmates, Reverend Mark Anthony Ventura of the Archdiocese of Tuguegarao and Reverend Rene Caligue of the Diocese of Bayombong. To the seminarians of the Our Lady of the Visitation Seminary and Brothers Haji and Junius for their service for the liturgy today. To all the others who have worked in one way or the other for this celebration, you edify me with the work you have done and inspire me the courage to be more generous and work not for myself but for others. I know the amount of sacrifice one has to bear in serving others. After seeing you for the past month, especially for the past few days, the temptation to be relevant, simply because it is my ordination, is gone. My desire to be relevant is extinguished by the humble work you have shown. The remedy all the while was an example of genuine service. Yesterday, I was trying to get a feel of the preparations. And in my mind, I thought I should take control of things since I am the ordinandus. Proudly, I went about trying to check on last-minute preparations, thinking that I held power over people who were working. Then I sensed the temptation to be powerful lurking around. To teach myself how to behave, I sat down watching people work again. And I saw some of those people who contributed generously for my ordination. Miss Josephine Federico for my beautiful chalice, Dr. Ed Martin for my vestments, Miss Sheila Fallion, Miss Espolina for my additional vestments, Mrs. Maricarty of Kawayan for liturgical books, and to the following who have so given so generously for this ordination, to the parishioners of San Guillermo Isabela, thank you very much. The parishioners of St. James the Apostle Parish in Santiago City, Our Lady of the Pillar in Cagayan City, in Santo Niño de Praga Parish in Bordon, St. Matthias of Tumawini, and some others, the doctors of the provincial hospital, thank you very much. You are the people who are blessed with means. Means today can be mistaken for power. As now I recall your contributions, I can say the true power does not lie in having, but in giving. The desire for power is extinguished by your service for me through the generosity you have shown. You made me realize that no one is so blessed enough that he does not need anything. No one is independent enough that he can do everything. Power finds expression in service. Again, yesterday, I was listening to the choir rehearse, and my ears could not help but notice the mistakes here and there. I wanted to do something about it. Anyway, they would not mind, I thought. But I too had things to do, and maybe I just wanted to prove myself again that I was good in music. There, I thought, the temptation to be spectacular came in. I am blessed with so many talents that I cannot help but stand out over the rest sometimes. But at this point, I would like to thank people, the people behind who I am and what I can do. For the past 8 years, I have been in seminary formation. I would like to thank the following. My boss, my present rector, and my former prefect of discipline, Reverend Father Jerry Dakiwag, for all the support and the concern to the duration of this ordination. Thank you, Father. Father Marshall Bartolome, present procurator of the seminary, my former parish priest, and the parish priest of San Guillermo, for the same support and an available ear whenever I needed it. Reverend Father Paco Albano, you will always be my mentor and my father. Reverend Father John Labawal, Reverend Father Nick Bakidar, the former rectors of ICST, and very Reverend Father Lain Mayo, the present rector of ICST, my thesis advisor, and all the formators of ICST for all the opportunities you offered me in ICST and all the challenges you gave me, those many projects that I was able to accomplish during my stay in ICST, the many early mornings I would go to bed because of music, because of designs, because of programs and the like, made me appreciate how to offer my life to people in silence and in an unnoticed manner. The true essence of sacrifice is that it is done unnoticed. Thank you very much. For my formators at the Thomas Aquinas Major Seminary in Apari, where I first entered to study philosophy, thank you very much. To the clergy of the Archdiocese of Tigaraw, my humble beginnings go back to you, for you have, for having had the chance to serve you as an organist in my younger years. Thank you very much. To the clergy of the Diocese of Ilagan, especially to Father Atong, Father Patrick Pua, Amakaloy Marquez, Father Arnold Sajas, Father Herman Bugatti, Father Bong Lazano, Father Patrick Caro, Monsignor John, and in a very special way, Monsignor Gatan, thank you very much for welcoming me in your parishes during Christmas breaks, semestral breaks, and summer apostolate assignments, and for allowing me to serve the people in your parishes. You kept me busy traveling and going to one parish from one parish to another by the favors you have asked, but nonetheless, made my break more meaningful and more fruitful. Reverend Joseph Nakwa, my bishop, most of the time I cannot find the words to say and use for such a simple servant of God. Thank you, Bishop, in your own little way, by the way you do your task and go to places to attend to people, helping them in any way you can. You have made a very deep impact in my life. Lastly, to Reverend Father Tony Ancheta, for having been my spiritual director for the past 8 years. Father, you know my relationship with God more than anybody else. Thank you for the effort of keeping my feet down to the ground when my pride sets in. I want to own this moment, but as I thought of it, it is not mine at all. In the midst of those called by God to serve, and those who have cultivated the desire in me to serve, and those whose lives of service I look to for inspiration, I want to be spectacular and great, but I am nothing compared to the service you, my dear clergy, have exemplified. My desire to be spectacular in my own way is humbled by the way you have shown and allowed me to work for others and serve them with all that I am. Again, service, after all, was the remedy for the need to be spectacular. From this time on, I will not be reading anything because I want these things to come from my heart. First of all, I would like to thank the Sisters of St. Paul of Chartres. I spent 16 years in your venerable institution, Sister. I am proudly Apollinian, and thank you for instilling in me the value of excellence and the basic values that a Christian should have. Thank you very much to the different chapels, the different communities that I observed when I was a student in Tugigaraw, and when I was a very young professional in Tugigaraw. To all my teachers in St. Paul, to all my professors who are here, thank you very much for giving me the chance to cultivate my talents way back in college. To all my relatives who are here, I have seen a lot of you during communion. Thank you for coming, and you know that I don't really see you very well because I'm not really that of a sociable person. But nonetheless, thank you. Thank you for being here. From the bottom of my heart, I'd like to greet two of my friends. They have been my genuine friends, my genuine best friends since college. They are Miss Josephine Ilingan and Mrs. Raima Fe Narag Lagundi. Ate Joy and Raima, thank you very much. When you found me as a friend in college, I was a wreck, you know that. And thank you for the patience of dealing with me and all my insecurities that time. And it has been 12 years, and we hope for more years to come of genuine friendship. Thank you for being there always for me. For the people, for some other people that they would like to take now, especially I see Tita Melba, and I see some of our benefactors in the seminary. Thank you very much for helping me out, but more so, thank you for helping out the seminary. And please, I would like to make this advertisement now with the permission of my rector. Please continue to help our seminary. You have seen our seminarians serving. Kawawa naman sila. They have been working for the past weeks for the diocese. And please, please help out with anything that you can for our seminary and for our future priests. And now, I would like to address my family. And I hope you won't mind if I speak in our language at home. Ma, Pa, Ronnie, Lord, and Teresa. Amok nga madiyo kayat ni Kastoy. Amok nga madiyo kayat ni nakadat mga tao. Amok nga madi tayo kayat ni nagdadakilan mo na yung celebrasyon. Mayat tibiyak tayo nga datay lagiurik ni Balay. Mayat tibiyak tayo nga datay lagserservi tipada tayo mga tao. Ma, and Pa, I have imbagak hindi ka nakayo dito yun imbagak manin agyaman na ipakpakita yung kanya nga panagtulong isa bali nga tao agyaman na kaya sakripisyo nga ipakpakita yung para kanya dito yung tatati isublik ibadak na tao hang kayo nga taktaka no apay ni London is into public safety and Teresa is into health services. And all of us now are in the line of service for other people, not for ourselves, but for other people. Iti amin na iti juban yami, deja ito ang kumasusuktan. So maawatan na kumano, mas kaya 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 banbanlog, maawatan na kumano, kaya mas kaya ito ang maturog, maawatan na kumano, kaya tumagpulbuyat para tipatak na tao. Deja gabing kinakikita pada kayo. Agyaman at loob. Ladies and gentlemen, an applause for my parents and my family, please. And at the end, I hope I was able to convince you that this affair is not about me. It's about you, whom I am serving, and about the God called me to serve. I am but a servant, and proudly for the past years, I have been doing it in my own way. And at this point, I would like to ask for apologies, for forgiveness, especially to our clergy, for my limitations in my service to you. And for you, my dear people, in my limitations in serving you, I am very, very sorry if I hurt you in one way or the other. Thank you very much for coming. And please remember always that in everything that we do, may it always be done for the greater glory of God.
We give another applause to Reverend Father Jomar Castaneda. The bishop will conclude the Mass. Our new priest, Father Jomar, will give his blessing, and then the picture taking of the newly ordained priest, and then the kissing of the hands. See you later at the Misa de Gracia. See you on Monday for another ordination, and thank you very much. Let us all stand. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, who founded the church and guides her still, protect you in his unfailing grace, that you may faithfully discharge the office of a priest. Amen. May God make you a servant and a witness of divine love and truth in the world, and a faithful minister of reconciliation. Amen. May God make you a true pastor, who nourishes the faithful with living bread and the word of life, that they may continue to grow into the one
body of Christ.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
May it please the Divine Majesty that everything turn out for His greater praise and glory. May He always, with His customary infinite mercies, be our protection and help. We ask this in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. May we invite our Reverend Priests to come forward for a picture taking so that this moment is captured forever. And then the kissing of hands of the newly ordained priest, Father Jomar, will be held. And then your personal gifts may be given to him. Wayano na sa yaya umakan ang naggagapan.
Father.